Hello viewers, my name is Mr. Devanja, and in our last video we talked about two theorems in circle geometry, whereby we talked about this opposite angle in the cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary, and we also talked about that the exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to the opposite interior angle of that cyclic quadrilateral. And we use these two theorems to solve problems. But today's theorem, we are still on circle geometry or circle theorem. And today's theorem, I'm going to talk about the theorem you can see on the screen right now that says a tangent to a circle is perpendicular to the radius drawn to its point of contact. A tangent to a circle is perpendicular to the radius drawn to its point of contact. What do you mean by a tangent? A tangent is a line that is drawn to touch a point on the circumference of a circle. That is, when you have a circle and you now have a line that is drawn, a straight line drawn to touch a point on the circumference of the circle, that means that line is a line of what? Tangent. As you can see on the screen right now, this line AB is a tangent because it's touching the circumference of the circle at point T here. So that means this line AB is a tangent. A tangent is a line that is touching the circumference of the circle at a point. So it's touching this circle at point T here. So what the theorem is saying is that if there is a line that is drawn from the center of the circle that is perpendicular to that tangent, that means the angle between the line drawn from the center of the circle and the tangent is 90 degrees. That is, when you draw when you have a radius from the center of the circle, and you now draw the radius to touch that tangent, you can see this radius here is touching this tangent AB at this point T. It's saying that the angle that exists between this radius and this tangent is 90 degrees. This angle here is 90 degrees. Also, this angle here is also 90 degrees, as you can see. So, as you can see, OTB. Is equal to OTA, that is the angle here. So they are equal to 90 degrees. That's what the theorem is saying, that anytime you have a tangent to a circle and there is now a radius drawn from the center of the circle to that is perpendicular to that tangent, that means the angle between them is 90 degrees. That's what the theorem is talking about. I'm going to use it to solve problems very soon. Now, if you look at the slide, what you are seeing now on the screen right now, you can see that you're having a circle and you're having a zest line touching the circle at this point. So you can see that this line is a line of tangent. Also, you can see there's a line drawn from the center of the circle, which is perpendicular to that tangent, and that line is a radius. So that means, from the theorem we just proved now, that means the angle that is here is 90 degrees. So if this angle here is 90 degrees and you have this angle here to be 72 degrees, you have to find angle hex. You can see that this is a triangle now formed. So sum of angle in a triangle is going to be 180 degrees. And now you're having this 72 plus 90 degrees here plus here, so we give us 180 degrees. Sum of angle in a triangle. From there, 72 plus 90 degrees will give us 162 degrees plus x equals 180. From there, you can find our hex by removing 162 from 180. That will give us 18 degrees. That means this angle x here is 18 degrees. Also, you can see on the screen right now that TA is a tangent at A. This line TA here, this line here is a tangent at A to a circle. So you can see that this line TA is touching this circle here at point A here. That means that line is a line of tangent. So AB is a chord. This line AB is a chord. And the angle BAT, that is this angle here is S degrees. You have to show that angle BOA is 2S degrees. Angle BOA, that is the angle that is here, is 2s degrees. You have to show that, given what you are having on the screen right now. And if you look at the theorem we just proved now, that the total angle here, because this is a radius and this is a line of tangent, so therefore this radius is perpendicular to this tangent, that means total angle here is going to be 90 degrees. We just proved that theorem now. Now, if this total angle here is 90 degrees and we already have this angle here to be S degrees, then we can find this small angle inside this triangle. How do we find that? Since total angle here is 90 degrees, if you remove this S from 90 degrees, that will give us this angle here. So here you'll be having 90 minus X degree. So this angle is 90 minus.